Just a few months ago, we were asking Ben when it might stop raining as flooding impacted several areas of our state. And climate scientists say this weather whiplash between extremes is growing more common. So what does that mean for those who depend on the growing season? Jennifer Hoff looked into it.
Degler Farms is hard to miss, one of the last in Chanhassen, though focusing less on crops that have been harder to grow.
We went to agritourism, trying to rely on more of what we can control.
People can expect pumpkins and hay rides, but this?
We are on a combine, a converted combine, that now we use as a ride.
The unique experience is part of owner Gail Degler's future plans as climate change continues to affect agriculture.
I mean, back in the 30s, it took almost a decade to get out of that drought, where now you can do it in 6, 8, 10 months.
The shifting weather is happening more quickly, according to Dr. Suzi Clark, who studies and teaches climate adaptation and resilience at the University of Minnesota.
We can no longer assume that we know what's going to happen in the next season based off of what happened in this season. And so we have to be prepared to adapt quickly.
She says the patterns are also warmer and wetter, the top 10 years on record, all happening since 1997.
But there's a big caveat to that wetter, because it's not happening uniformly across the year. And in fact, we also have seen larger swings from really wet to really dry.
Take this year, when less than half the normal amount of snow fell in winter, with extraordinarily warmer temperatures adding to an already persistent drought. Then summer rains relieved them. But the record-setting amount led to flooding and farmers' fields looking like lakes. Only now to then experience the driest September, driving the state back into a drought.
The ground so dry, Degler can hardly till it, which is something they have to do in the fall. And if they don't, it could impact planting next spring.
I've heard of people breaking equipment. I mean, right now there's cracks in the ground that I haven't seen for quite a while.
Degler's yields are average at best this year. But he's hopeful his new venture will be more stable than some of our changing seasons.
It's just something you have to try to prepare for. You're going to have to live with it one way or another.
And also what happens in the future is also up to us. So it's our choice in this day and age to decide not only how we change our behavior, but how we respond now.
Jennifer Hoff, CARE 11 News.
Dr. Clark says some of the things everyone can do now at all levels across the state include installing irrigation, watering trees, and capturing this and storing large rain amounts. And that can range from rain barrels at your house to creating rain gardens that can slow runoff and improve water quality.